There are three reaction pathways by which the elements of water, HOH, can be eliminated across a carbon-carbon single bond in order to produce carbon-carbon double bonds. And these three reaction pathways are really broken down according to which bond breaks first. We're going to take a look at these different reaction pathways. You've already seen them, but I'll remind you of them here, and we'll put them all together in one spot so that you can look at them and compare them. And then we'll also look at whether or not these are common to biological elimination. So in the first reaction pathway, the E1 pathway, what goes on is the loss or the cleavage of the carbon-oxygen bond first. The corresponding leaving group would be hydroxide or possibly a phosphate ester, and we would have a carbocation intermediate. The second step of this process then is going to be the electrophile dissociation step, where a proton is going to be lost. H plus is the electrophile that leaves in order to create the carbon-carbon double bond. It turns out that the E1 mechanism is relatively rare in biological systems. Let's take a look at the second pathway. In the second pathway, what we're doing is we're having the carbon-hydrogen bond break first. It's essentially a deprotonation reaction, so you can imagine, for example, that in this second pathway there's a base that's coming along and removing that hydrogen. Now, generally, the formation of just a unstabilized carbanion is not likely to take place, but if we could find a way with, say, an electron withdrawing group in one of these positions, it might be possible the acidity of that carbon-hydrogen bond might be good enough that we could make a stabilized carbanion with an electron withdrawing group like a ketone. The next step in this E1CB mechanism is the beta elimination, and we know that the beta elimination can have as its leaving group list these very poor leaving groups like hydroxide. And so that's a viable pathway, and indeed the E1CB is actually found in biological systems. Beta hydroxy ketones, which in the last webcast we learned were the products of aldolase enzymes, beta hydroxy ketones in fact commonly undergo elimination by the E1CB pathway. The last of the three pathways is the concerted E2 pathway, and in this case what happens is the simultaneous bond breaking of both the carbon-hydrogen and the carbon-oxygen bonds, and simultaneous bond making of the pi bond. The E2 reaction pathway is also found in biological systems, either as the conversion of the hydroxide group to the phosphate, which is a better leaving group than phosphate, or it is sometimes found in with beta-hydroxycarboxylic acids. We're also going to look at the stereochemistry, and we'll look at this in some detail. And when we talk about stereochemistry, we're talking about whether or not the hydroxide and the hydrogen atom are on the same side or on opposite sides of the plane that I'll draw for you, the plane that contains the carbon-carbon single bond, which gets converted into the carbon-carbon double bond. So if I can just go ahead and fill this plane in, with shade that a little bit so that you can see, this is the plane that defines whether the hydrogen atom and the hydroxide group are on the same side or on opposite sides. As they're shown here, this would be the opposite side. That would be anti-elimination, and if they were on the same side, that is, the elimination were to take place on the same side, that would give rise to the syn-elimination. The last thing I'll say about it is just try to imagine from this picture how these remaining groups, which I will color in red, how these remaining groups will end up looking in the final product. So notice that those two groups, which are coming out towards us, are on the same side of the double bond. When those tetrahedral carbon atoms collapse into a planar atom, and then the groups that are in the back, let me see if I can color them a different color. Maybe I will make them gray. So if those groups are gray, then the groups in the back, when these tetrahedral atoms collapse into a carbon-carbon double bond that's a trigonal planar system, the two atoms that are in the back will be on the same side of the double bond. So the red ones are in front, they stay on the same, they're on the same side of the double bond as they are drawn here, and the gray atoms, when they collapse down into the double bond takes place, they're on the same side. So the key thing is, whether you eliminate from the syn or the anti-conformation, the groups, the substituents, will stay on that side. All right, so the stereochemistry, turns out it's going to help us understand what's the mechanism. Let's look at the stereochemistry. For the E1 reaction, it could take place either by a syn elimination or an anti-elimination. With beta-hydroxy ketones, that could, and the E1CB mechanism, that could also take place by a syn or an anti-elimination. And you can see that because if you think about the mechanism, we first make this carbanion, and during the lifetime of that carbanion, there could be rotation about the carbon-carbon double bond, and so we would have lost the information about the stereochemistry, the relationship between the hydrogen and the hydroxide. It's only the E2 reaction, which generally has a preference for one type of stereochemical elimination, and this is the one that requires the anti-elimination. Almost always, the E2 will go through the anti-elimination pathway. All right, so the last thing I want to do in this webcast is to just emphasize the importance of this electron withdrawing group for the E1CB mechanism. So let's take a look at the E1CB mechanism, because it is so common as a pathway for elimination in biological systems. And so I want you to recognize the pattern of this beta-hydroxy ketone when we're likely to see the E1CB mechanism take place. So what we're going to be looking for is these beta-hydroxycarbonyl derivatives, and remember that we take and consider the alpha carbon, the one next to the carbonyl carbon, and so the beta carbon is the one that is two carbons away from the carbonyl carbon, and that's where the hydroxy group is. Whenever we have a beta-hydroxycarbonyl, we can eliminate the elements of water by deprotonating that alpha carbon to make the corresponding carbanion, which of course is stabilized as its enolate resonance contributor. So that enolate anion is going to make that hydrogen atom more acidic, and so that's why it's possible to do the deprotonation and use the E1CB pathway. Now the beta elimination kicks out the hydroxide, the double bond is installed. That E1CB mechanism is a very important mechanism in biological systems, very common to the pattern of functional groups that you see here, and so that's worth putting in the memory.